Pop squat. Coming at ya. We have got another track from Jace, who is apparently now not spelling his name iayze, which I heartily agree with. This was sent in by Givenchy JF, and that's somebody new to sending me stuff, but Givenchy is actually one of my patrons. If you want to find out more about that, there's information down below in the description. And the patrons get a lot of love here on the channel because they send me money every month, and I appreciate that. This is Jace's song God, which came out in March of 2022, produced by Royal Ansem, Reset, and Dat Kid Mix. Shot by Sienna Burmis. This is the official music video. It is a minute and 58 seconds long, so not a very long song, which I think is pretty typical of Jace's stuff. It's not very long. And I'm curious about this. It is Genius lists it only as rap. I'm trying to think if Jace is known for purely rap or if he's... Yeah, so probably a lot of plug type stuff. He's often worked with like Summers Can Can and One Dada Forever. Don't know who that is, among others. Jace expresses his versatility through his large discography, from ambient tracks to his harder trap tracks to his sad or upbeat tracks. Jace is also known for his high work ethic, from releasing four projects in the span of January 2021 to accounting to over 16 projects released in 2020. Or you could write that in a way that actually made sense. Jace claims some of his biggest inspirations include Chief Keef, FBG Duck, I think I said that, Doo-Wop Kane, and his close friend Summers. I don't think I've read this before off of Genius. I think I've read information about him elsewhere. Let's get into this. Like I said, this was sent in by Givenchy JF, so maybe they will comment on this video, but thank you for sending in some money and or being a patron and sending in the suggestion. I appreciate it. I know a lot of people have asked for this reaction over the last few months, so I'm happy to finally be able to give it to them. So here is God from Jace. Let's do it. I do have lyrics on here. That was a very anime sound, that shing, 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 shing.
God, if you been thinking about me, thinking about me, thinking about me, remember when they laughed at me, remember when they laughed at me, you turned your back on me, I can't let you in, back on that stupid shit, why do you hear me cry, why do you hear me cry, why do you hear me cry, if I ain't laughed at me.
Sorry, I didn't mean to back up like that. I love that he's doing this song. I love that he's doing this song, because it strikes me that this is going to be, and we're only one verse in, this is going to be, it is, him hopefully being honest with us, talking about some of the stuff that he's grappled with, and me personally, I rate myself an atheist, if not an extremely, extremely agnostic person, atheist. And it's cool to see somebody stand up and talk about this stuff, about the fact that, like, God, have you been thinking about me? You turned your back on me. I can't let you in. Like, my life is... This is what I read into that. Like, you turn your back on me as my life is fucked. And you did that, like, and that's the sort of weird thing about having a belief in God is that God somehow does something for you, or doesn't do things for you, or screws you over, like throws these challenges in front of you, and in some way to make you a better person. That's bullshit. Life is just life. Like God is yourself and other people. The devil is yourself and other people. It's not a real thing, and I love that he's talking about these questions that he is having. I'm not saying he doesn't believe in God. Clearly from this song he does believe him, and he's just said, no, fuck you, I'm done with you, I'm not participating. And it's great, because I think we're going to get a super honest song about sort of the stuff he's gone through, what he's thought about, the pain he's had in his life. And there you go, I'm talking a whole bunch, and we haven't even heard the whole song, so let's keep going.
Remember when they laughed at me? You turned your back on me. I can't let you in. Back on this stupid shit. God, do you hear me crying? God, do you hear me crying? God, do you hear me crying? If I could ask one more time, I'm done trying. And we just need some time, turn out the lights. When it get dark, you cry, you won't like nights. Her face been in my head, I can't get out. I'm thinking about blowing my head if it don't come out. Starting to get pissed off, them demons ain't coming out. You look good and I got that coming out. Cause you're in the hood and we got no running out. What's that nigga who you gon' make fun now? God, have you been thinking about me? Thinking about me, thinking about me, Remember when they laughed at me, Remember when they laughed at me? You turned your back on me. I can't let you in. Back on this stupid shit. God, do you hear me cry? God, do you hear me cry? God, do you hear me cry?
So definitely the end of this second verse. End of the second verse is the part that is most. I gotta ask one more time. I'm done trying. If I gotta ask one more time, I'm done trying. If you just need some time, turn on the lights. When it get dark, you crying. You don't like nights. Her face been on my head. I can't get it out. I'm thinking about blowing my head if it don't come out. Starting to get pissed off when demons ain't coming out. Hit her good and I got a something that the genius people couldn't get. Who you gonna make fun of now? Who is he talking about there with her face bent on my head? I can't get it out. Is this an ex-girlfriend? Is this somebody who died? I just don't know. But even listening to this, like you can hear sort of the pain in it. God, do you hear me cry? God, do you hear me cry? Remember when they laughed at me? I can also hear that in his voice too. You turn your back on me. I can't let you in. Back on this stupid shit. It's a really good song. It's a good song, and in its own way, it actually also reminds me of. It's more personal. But it reminds me of, XTC, the song Dear God, where Andy Partridge goes through this whole thing about God and, you know, if God is real, how he's a psychotic, sociopathic killer, basically, not in much more poetic ways. And it's a fantastic song. It probably is one of the songs that really started my very strong rejection of religion. And this is similar in its own way. But it's all about him and what he had to go through and what he's had to put up with. And despite the fact that he's now successful, probably makes a pretty good amount of money. He's probably set up for life if he's really careful, even if things completely go south for him from now on. He's not able to continue to make music. He probably is set. But that doesn't mean as he's got a happy life, right? And he's still dealing with all that stuff that happened in the past that he still has as part of his experience in life. And so I like this as sort of a personal blah. Which I use that often, like he needs to get this out of him, and this is how he's chosen to do it. And I think it's really brave, because even now in America, for a lot of people, and this is only in America, to come out as not being religious or to be questioning God so strongly can be a really dangerous thing to do with your family, with friends, with people in your community, with anybody, right? With just the public, it can be a really dangerous thing to do. Yeah, I really like it. I think it's good. I think it's a good song. And I hope he continues to think about this stuff. And I don't care where he ends up. If he decides he's going to welcome God back into his life and be religious again, fine. Whatever. That's your choice. It's your life. It's not what I would do. But, you know, I just maybe haven't gone fully around the bend and decided to do that again. Who knows? I think this is really good. There you go. Pop Squad. Check it out. I hope you like this one. Who sent this in? Givenchy JF, thank you for sending this in. Like I said, I know a lot of people have been wanting me to react to this for a while. And it's good. It's a sweet song. And I know it's not meant to be a sweet song, but it is, because it's an honest song. And that you can tell he has spent a lot of time thinking about this, even though the song is only 2 minutes long and there's not a whole lot of lyrics. It just comes across really honestly. And that's all you can ever really want from any artist, is an honest piece of their work. And this is really good. So, thanks again, Pop Squad. Have a good night. Bye-bye.